this same process of using the transpose function, create them, and then editing things and saving them as views is basically the way we've done every example that we've ever shown, and it seems to work pretty well. So let me just open up Excel and bring the data into PowerPivot. Open up a brand new spreadsheet. So this is Excel 2010 with PowerPivot in it, and if we go and look at PowerPivot, you'll see that there's nothing in it. So this is the way it comes out of the box. And what we want to do now is bring that data into this spreadsheet so we can do some things with it. Probably the most common way to bring the data in is through some kind of relational connection. The way you get to that is there's a little disk here which sort of shrinks when you have screens that aren't that big, but if you make this wider, it should come out and say, ah, other data sources. And when you click on that, you can see the list. These Microsoft ones are, of course, repeated again, but to connect to the PI server, you would use this selection at the bottom that says OLEDB data sources, and click Next. And here is where you can give your connection a name. You have to supply a string, which most people don't know from memory, so there's a wizard. Click on the Build button, and you get to this little Microsoft dialog that allows you to pick the provider you're interested in, which happens to be installed on your machine, and then you fill out the necessary information to construct the connection string. You can see the list, and down near the bottom, because I've installed the PI OLEDB Enterprise, there is the two PI OLEDB connectors or providers are listed there. The one you want for this is the PI OLEDB Enterprise, because it's the one that connects to AF and brings you all the AF attributes and the hierarchy and all that jazz. And then if you hit Next, it's a security setting, single sign-on PI, which has to be done first. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. It's under this All tab. So if you come down here and let me click on it, right, this guy, and you edit it. And you have to type in SSPI here first. Once that's configured, then you'll be able to connect. By the way, once you set up this connection, you'll see that refreshing the data, you don't have to do this stuff anymore. This all gets stored here. So this is just the initial setup, I guess. Then if we go back to the connection tab, this is where you would type in where it says data source. This would be your AF server name. So that's just my laptop. And then if you want, you can test this connection. There's a little button at the bottom. You get the dialog that says everything's okay. And then down here, where you're picking the data source or whatever it is, oops, you're going to see again that same list of all your AF databases. The one we want is this one that says fleet generation. So I'll go ahead and pick that. And hit OK. Now all we've done through that thing is basically put this in there, this little string. It tells which provider, which AF database, the security settings, how you want to log in, that kind of stuff. That's all this does. And then if we move on, what's going to happen is I get to the next step of this dialog, and I have a couple of choices, and the default is the one we're going to take, because that's just going to basically expose the tables and views that are available to me to bring into PowerPivot. So if you go to the next step, remember I've already told it I want the fleet database, and now what happens is it basically gives you a list of all the tables that you saw that are there for reference that could bring back something which I haven't really configured, but at the bottom is the list of views that I made. So down here, these four guys here are the ones that I've defined. But what we're going to do is just check this one and this one. And those are the two tables of data that we saw in our spreadsheet. And when we do that, then those two tables will be brought in by PowerPivot, and we'll get them as tables here. So this is why I think the views are the best way to do this, because if you maybe make your names a little bit more like, 30 days data for this or whatever you want, so that it's obvious to people what these are. You click on those and then refresh them, and what happens is those tables then come in into PowerPivot, and you'll get like a little green success thing, and basically that's the data. Okay, so here are two of the tables that we showed at the very beginning, and we've got that done. So if I want to refresh that data, then all I have to do is go up to this refresh button. I can either refresh all, and basically it's going to do exactly what I just did over again, Or I could pick refresh singular, and it's only going to refresh the table that I happen to be looking at.